Good morning, children. Hope you've had a great weekend. Welcome to our last week before half term. Now, as we often do on a Monday, we've got a new theme this week. And I've written up, there are 10 spaces on the board here. And it's a long and tricky word. And I'm just going to give you an example of the sort of thing that we're talking about. Okay, and I need a prop to do that. And I brought this with me. And whatever I do with this, it keeps doing something there. And here, even here, it'll even be stood on, and I think it'll still work. Shall we try? Ibrahim, do you want to come and stand on this ball? Eloise, can you shuffle back a little bit? And we'll let Ibrahim, I'm not going to touch you, Ibrahim, but you hold on to the tail. Stand on that ball. Go on, get all your weight on it. All your weight on it. Jump up and down a little bit on it. Oops, that's it. That'll do. Well done. Thank you, Ibrahim. Now let's pick you, go back and sit down again. And then, even though Ibrahim's just stood on the ball, it'll still do that. It'll still do that. It'll still do that. Okay, it will bounce back. And that really is our theme. Do you know what the word is? Well, a bit of a long word with 10 letters. It is resilience. And we have two people to remind us here what resilience is. So you two going to stand up? You're going to keep yourself apart from each other? Right, now tell us, what does resilience mean?
Resilience means to bounce back.
Just say that again so everybody can hear.
Resilience means to bounce back.
Oh, brilliant. Round of applause. Sit down, you two. Make sure you keep apart. Well done. So that's to bounce back. And really, what I wanted to do in today's assembly is give you some examples of all of us have had to do things where we have to be able to bounce back, where when things don't go right, we keep working hard to try and put them right. And I know some of you saw when I first came to Greenbank, when I very first came to Greenbank, I told you about me learning to juggle. It took me ages to be able to do that. And that was great. But then I realized, well, what could be another challenge for me? And it was to juggle with four different balls. And I practiced really, really hard, even when I was away skiing in the winter. And I've practiced this summertime. And what you have to do is do one hand at a time, like this, and practice and practice and practice, and then put them all together. But as you'll see, I'm still struggling just a little bit. And I've been practicing for over a year. I keep going over and over it again and keep trying. And I'm still not there yet, but I promise you I'm going to keep going. And I wondered and I asked the teachers, well, how many things have you had to keep going? How many things have you had to bounce back when things don't go right? Here's some examples. Have a great week, and I look forward to hearing about when you've shown resilience.
Hello, everybody. A time when I had to be resilient was probably about 5 years ago when I had a really bad fall from my horse and I tore a disc in my back, which is quite a bad injury. I woke up the day after I did it at about 3 o'clock in the morning and I couldn't move from the waist down, and I really thought that I was paralysed. It was really, really scary. And I went to hospital and they realised what I'd done. But because I hadn't had any treatment on it, as soon as I did it, it was quite swollen and quite sore, and so the injury ended up being quite a lot worse than it could have been if I'd dealt with it straight away. And it took me probably about 10 months to get back to my normal self, because the pain was so bad every time I wanted to move or do any exercise, or even it kept me awake at night. I couldn't sleep because of the pain. I had to have quite a long time off work because I wasn't able to be knocked or anything like that. I had to be really careful, and all I wanted to do was keep still because every time I moved, the pain was so bad. But I knew that that was really bad for me to just sit still and not try and do the exercise that I needed to try and get better. And sometimes it would be better for a few weeks and then it would go back to how it was, and the pain would be really awful. And I had to see lots of different doctors and nobody was quite sure why it was taking so long to sort itself out, and it made me at times feel quite down because it's not nice to live with lots of pain all the time. So I think I had to be really resilient and had to think that it would get better, and I had to put the work in order for it to get better. And now it is a lot better, and I can do everything that I used to do. Sometimes I still get the odd little bit of pain if I don't stay active, but nothing like I had in those 10 months when I was in recovery from it. So I think that even though things are hard and can sometimes hurt you, you have to keep positive and try and keep pushing through the pain and the hard times, because you know that things will be better on the other side, like they are now.
Right, it's a good tune, isn't it? Top thumping. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You ain't never gonna keep me down. Now, let's put aside the poor grammar for a moment. Now, it's a great sentiment. Getting knocked down, but getting up again is exactly what we're talking about with resilience. Now, that song reminds me of my teenage years. And I'm gonna tell you a little story about my teenage years and my resilience. Now, when I was a teenager, I loved playing football, still do, did before I was a teenager. What happened then is I was going to in school. I wanted to get in the school football team. Now, it's quite a big school that I went to. There's a lot of children there. The year sixes will find next year there's more competition for the school team, and there might be more players, and it might be harder to get into. And that's what I found. So there was a big pool of players, and I wasn't good enough to get in the school team. I went to every training session, tried my best, but there was always a group of players who were better than I was, and I was frustrated. I kept going, kept trying, still wasn't breaking in, and it was right, they were stronger players, and I didn't want to get picked out of sympathy. I wanted to be good enough to get in the team on merit. So what I did was I just kept going to the training sessions. I listened to the coach, listened to everything he had to say about how to improve. And it was a bit frustrating because he was concentrating more on the players who were in the team than the players who weren't in the team. So they were getting even better, more ahead of where I was. I had a play for another team outside school, Winnershire Amateurs. Some of you might know them. So I listened to everything their coach had to say. So I took on board everything. I went to watch United every week, which was great. And then we were good. And watched what the players did, where to be. I read all the books. And what I realised was I'm not skillful or talented enough to do all the stuff that the really good players were doing. But I could do what I did well. What I did well was I understood the game, and I could make myself really fit so that I could never tire in the game. I could always be in the right place at the right time and always choose the good option. And then eventually, it took me until year 9 before I got picked for the team. Say they only had one team, and there was a lot of children in the school. So I eventually got picked for year 9. I was so excited. I was also nervous. It's nerve-wracking. I always get nervous before I play football, even now. But then I was very nervous in the first game, but I was really pleased as well. It was my third year of being in the school, and I finally got picked. And playing defence in the first minute or two of the game. I haven't kicked the ball yet. It was a shot, it was going in. Our keeper wasn't going to save it. I couldn't reach it with my legs, but I could reach it with my hand. So I saved it, tipped the ball around the post, stopped a goal, and gave away a penalty and got sent off and kicked the ball for the team. I've been trying to get in there for 3 years. And the first touch I had was tipping around the post. And I've been sent off before I'd even had a chance to kick it. Then they scored the penalty. So I didn't even help the team. But I tried. So it took another few weeks before I got in the team again. And then once I did get in the team, I got picked again and again and again. Now, I wasn't a spectacular player. I'm still not. What I did was I helped make the other players who were more talented, more skillful than I was, I helped make the team better and helped them perform and do all the wonderful goals and things. And it took a long time to get there, but I think because it had taken me a long time to get good enough to be in the school team, it meant more to me maybe than it did to the other players who found it easy. So, and that's true with so many things in life, where the harder you have to work to achieve it, the more special it is. So even if things are tough, and if you really want it, just keep going and it'll be even more special when you do achieve it. And that is what we mean by resilience.
Right, so resilience. I've been asked to describe two areas where I've, well, not two, but I'm going to share two. One of resilience, of where I felt I've learned from that experience and how that's helped me to progress to where I am now, I suppose. But I think when I first started off playing sports, you know, you start off, and actually it was way back to my primary, and it was running and in running races, and you know, we all know I class myself as a keen sports person. And that has come from losing. You know, that element of not winning the race, and I can remember one specific one where I didn't win. But that then, and it was my dad then who, because he could see how upset I was, taught me that actually, if I want to improve, then I've got to practice. So I had to be resilient in the sense of, right, I didn't win that race, but I'm going to go join the local athletics club, Southland Athletics Club, and then I've, you know, started to train more, and then I'm in football and lots of different, actually all those areas of not giving up from that one race, I think then inspired me to just look at how, from everything element of skill, sports skill, that I try and improve to make sure the next race I won. And then, you know, you inevitably lose one again, and then you go away and you practice, and in football wise and in rugby, it might be not being selected for the team. And again, all right, you've not got on the first team, so you go and play for the seconds. And then you learn, and you learn from experiences and your mistakes. And again, it's being resilient. It's not seeing that because I've not been given or I've not won a race that I should just give up. It's being resilient and saying, actually, no, I need to go away and practice hard and return and then show what I'm capable of. And I think when we look at that skill in sports, which I think is a lot where it appears with regards to resilience, I then think about some of my hobbies, like the DIY I do around the house. So, and in fact, it's in the garden at the moment. So I've got some new decking, and I've been cutting these decking. There was one particular cut that I found really challenging, and I measured it, and it was the angles of cut. So some maths in there, as you could imagine. So looking at how to cut that angle and then to slot it in very carefully. And I did it the first time and it wasn't quite right. And then I'm having to get another board, which is costing me money. So then I'm getting nervous because I'm spending more money and getting it wrong. So I'm moving on to my second board. But I think what I did was I stopped and I went away and I just gave myself a break from it. And I had to think carefully and return back. So rather than giving up and saying, no, I can't do it, I just spent time, and then I ended up spending longer on this one specific than I probably did for the whole area that I've decked. So it was that patience and again, resilience of not just going, well, that'll do. Okay, that cut that I've done because it wasn't quite good enough. I went away and I took my time until I managed, and I have. And actually, the flip side of that then is once you've spent so much time on it and you've worked so hard on something and you've been resilient, you actually feel 10 times better at the end of it. So yeah, the journey through that element of failure isn't nice. It's not nice for anybody. No one likes to fail. But the point is that you need to use that and drive yourself through it, because the other side of that is when you achieve it, when you have improved, you feel 10 times better. So yeah, there's my two examples of resilience.